Blog Talk Radio. Welcome to the Michael Mashey Show, broadcasting from our studios on the beautiful island of Anguilla. Michael is the director of entertainment for the Cuisinart Golf Resort and Spa in Anguilla and the owner of Michael Mashey Entertainment Agency, which has provided quality entertainment since 1985. To join the show live, call us at 516-418-5590. And now, here's Michael Mashey.
Hello, good afternoon. This is Michael Mashey, along with my brilliant producer and my wife, Blanca. Blanca, how are you, my darling?
I'm very well, thank you. Good morning, everybody.
And we are broadcasting to you, as always, live from Anguilla, here in the British West Indies. I know nobody knows where we are, but we're here in the beautiful island of Anguilla.
So it is a slice of paradise.
It actually is. And, you know, boy, every day we have some great guests, but today we really have a really great guest. Our guest today is an award-winning actress who's a veteran of the Broadway stage. She's got numerous television and movie credits to her name, and she's going to be appearing in a show called Sin Twisters 2 with Anita Gillette at the Metropolitan Room. Ladies and gentlemen, and Blanca, we have the fantastic Penny Fuller on the show. Penny, welcome to the show.
Welcome, Penny.
Thank you. Veteran, that sounds, I don't know, like I've been through the wars. Well, maybe I have, now that I think about it.
You've been through the Broadway war, right?
That's true. The showbiz wars.
Oh, well, it's wonderful to have you on the show. How are you?
I wish I was down there.
I'll tell you what,
why do I have to sit in my living room instead of down there?
I heard the weather's not that great up there right now. You're in New York,
well,
right?
Well, it's gray, which means if you have nothing to do, you can clean out your house, you know, your drawers and your bookcases and things. But I have to rehearse, so I can't do that.
Ah, so you are busy. It keeps you busy.
Yes.
We're going to have our stuff done.
Yeah, well, we have to get our show together, you see, because we've done this show before, but not for several months. And I had what I think is this wonderful idea, if I do say so myself, which is we're going to get it all ready, and the night before we open, or the day before we open, we're going to go out to the actors' home in New Jersey and do a warm-up show with them, for them.
Oh,
the actors' home is a place where wonderful old actors go to spend their waning years, I guess you'd say. And most of them are a little older than we are, but they know all the shows that we sing and all that. So I thought, well, what a great idea. We'll get a warm-up audience, and they'll get a nostalgic trip.
That sounds fantastic. That's a great idea. I wish
I
was there for that.
Yeah, I'm proud of that. Good. Okay.
So you are very busy, and of course you're working. When are you going to be doing the show, Sin Twisters? When is that going to be at the Metropolitan Room?
This is going to be on June 3rd and June 9th at 7 o'clock.
June 3rd and June 9th at 7 o'clock.
Okay, and for all of you that are listening to the show live, and of course you can always listen to this show once it's archived as well, we have all that information on the episode page where you can actually purchase tickets, and definitely a show not to miss. And, you know, it's funny, we were introduced to you just a few days ago. We had Richard Skipper on as a guest. You called in, and boy, he's great because he introduced us to you, and now you're on the show, and we're so glad to have you on.
Oh, that's so great, but I love the fact that I called him and he didn't know who I was, because I said, I'm the one without the red hair, and he
was
didn't
that funny?
Get it.
And you said, I'm not the twin. And he says, you're my twin?
You're my twin.
Oh, well, so much for making an impression. You know what I mean?
I know, right? Well, I want to tell you that we do have a caller on the line. So I want to get right to the calls when they come in, because I don't like to make people wait too long. But we're calling from the 845 area code, and I think I know who this is. You are on the air on Michael Mashey's live show with Penny Fuller. Who do we have on the line?
Well, I'm not a redhead either, but I'm the other one.
I agree with you.
I'm listening. Hello, Penny. I'm not going to take up any time. I just want to let everyone know that I'm listening.
Well, thank you. That's Richard Skipper.
I want to say this show is so much fun. You have to see the show. I've seen it. How many times have I seen it? A few times. But there was
Well, you've only seen this one twice, Richard. This one's new.
I know, but you did Sin Twisters, and now you've got Sin Twisters 2. And there's so much material. I mean, it celebrates our musical theater heritage, of course, your career and Anita Gillette's. And the interesting thing is, you know, you've got to do a Sin Twisters 3 with our sin brother, and that could be me.
Oh, I see. All right. That's fine. But let me just explain one thing.
Yes.
Let me explain one thing. Sin Twisters 2 is not spelled T-W-O. It's spelled Sin Twisters, comma, T-O-O.
Yes, we know that. Or your listeners should know that.
Well, that's why I said it.
Well, I'm not going to take any more time. I'm going to just sit back and listen. I love you, Penny, and I hope Anita's listening out there. But have a great show, and I'm listening.
Okay, great. Thanks, Richard.
Before you hang up, I want to just let people know that those of you that are in the New York area, this Wednesday, Richard Skipper celebrates. It's going to be a fantastic show, and that is the Triad Theater, correct?
That's correct, on 72nd Street in New York City.
And 7 p.m., right?
That's right. Okay. 8 o'clock.
Oh, 8 o'clock. I'm sorry. So, well, at least people get there early if they go at 7. So, but yeah, Richard Skipper celebrates.
Yes.
It's been a pleasure to work with you on that, and best of luck to you on that show.
Thank you so much.
All right, my friend. Thank you for calling in. I'll keep you
on
hold.
I'm just
going to
hang on.
Continue listening.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you, Richard.
Ah, we love Richard, huh, Penny?
I love him.
Oh, he's great. He is just great.
Yes, he is. He's real effervescent. I love it. That's a word that I use to describe him.
Now, I know that Blanca wants to ask questions that we're back.
Yeah. This is always my question.
Wait a second. It's going funny. I can't hear you. Why can't I hear you?
Can you hear us
now?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I have this burning question for any artist. It is, when did you develop your love of the theatrical arts?
Well, I was a little girl once upon a time, and I lived in Briarcliff Manor, New York. And I was very little. I was about 3, I think. I mean little. And my parents took me to a Broadway show, and it was called High Button Shoes. And in High Button Shoes was a man who played a character actor, and they said, "That's your uncle." I said, "That's my uncle?" And Uncle Bill was not actually my uncle. He had been married to my Aunt Dorothy, and they got divorced. But he came out to where we lived and spent time with me. Now, of course, I wanted to be a movie star when I was little. And so, but he started telling me about center stage and upstage and left stage and right stage, and he started instilling all these sort of, I don't know what you call it, respectful things about the theater, and I just thought it was wonderful. So I guess it started then, and I would say I was under 6. I'm not quite sure how much younger than 6 I was, but I was under 6. And that's when I started it, and started, my eyes got bigger and bigger every time they take me to the theater. Then I was torn between being a ballerina and an actress, of course.
Right.
But it seemed easier to be an actress, but let me tell you, I don't know.
Yeah, it is very difficult, very challenging to have a long career, and you most certainly are successful in acting, and a lot of people get out of it, you know, early on.
Yeah.
It is tough. It is very, very tough, very competitive.
Yeah.
And most people don't realize
that. Yeah,
it's
competitive, and now the world is changing. I mean, not only are we older, but the music, the style of things is changing. I mean,
yes.
I don't think I'm going to get hired to play a mother or a grandmother in a rap musical, frankly. So, I mean,
never say never.
I mean, I would play anything in Hamilton. It's
right.
So good, but, you know.
Right. Now, I think I know the answer to this question, but, of course, you have such a history in Broadway, television, and movies. Of the three, what's your favorite?
Well, definitely the theater. But the good thing about television, I didn't really do that many movies, but the good thing about television is, it's kind of over when it's over and you don't have to keep going and keep going and getting on the bus and going down to the theater and putting on your makeup and doing the show. So that's a nice thing. It's a nice break. But the creativity, it's the same, but also it's quite different to do television. It's like thinking loud. I think it was Mike Nichols said that film acting is like thinking loud. And, of course, on Broadway, you have to feel loud so that it is projected across the theater. You know,
that's a great way to describe it. Yeah.
The reason why I asked that, and for those of you listening out there that aren't aware, Penny's been in – she was in All the President's Men. She was in the movie The Beverly Hillbillies. And when it comes to television, you were Melrose Place, Law & Order, Judging Amy, Quantum Leap, Mad About You. And the list goes on and on. You've been on so many TV shows. It's just incredible.
Yeah, well, I went out there for a long time. Out there meaning L.A. instead of New York.
Sure.
And then
I'm assuming
you like
New York better.
I do. But then I had a little brief respite where I went to Atlanta – Georgia, and was a neurosurgeon's wife, and I had a baby, and then that didn't work out so well, playing a neurosurgeon's wife, so I went back to Los Angeles, and that's when I did a great deal of television, and I got a whole bunch of Emmy nominations, and I even got an Emmy, and
yes,
I keep thinking,
wonderful.
but I want to be in New York, and I finally, when my daughter went to college, I said, you can do anything. You live anywhere when you finish college, but get out of the West and go back to the East to college. And she did, and I moved back to New York then.
Oh,
right. And
wonderful.
Of course, that Emmy was for your role in The Elephant Man, the TV version of The Elephant Man, correct? Yeah.
Yes, that was.
That's so interesting. Now, getting back to Broadway, you worked with the fantastic Lauren Bacall.
I sure did. I absolutely adored her. She was... You know, everybody says she was terrifying. Well, maybe so, but the secret is she was terrified. So she was just scared. I mean, if you think she was 18 years old and she got her first movie and met Humphrey Bogart and married him. And, you know, and then now she was alone. And she was, I would say, one of my best friends. She really was. And I remember, because I replaced an applause out of town. And I remember they said, you're going to meet Miss Bacall now. And I thought, oh, God, let her know that if I'm good, it'll only help her. And she got it, and she loved it, and we were friends from then on.
That's amazing. You know, and for those of you that are listening to this, I would like to play for them a fantastic song that you did in that show, Applause. This is a wonderful song called One Halloween. Take a listen.
Remember that Halloween when you were nine? You wore a fairy queen costume of your own design. Well, look at you now. And you put on rouge and lipstick, though it wasn't allowed. You were so proud. And Daddy said, wash your face, you look like a whore. That's what he said. No more. And so you went upstairs, washed your face, took off your dress, threw it away, got into bed, as though it were the end of an ordinary day. And outside, the moon continued to shine. Remember that Halloween when you were nine? Well, damn you, Daddy. Look at your little girl now! Collected. No sign of panic. She's alive. She's alive. So alive. I'm wound up like a spring that's been tightened. Dreamy and dizzy, but not a bit frightened. I'm alive. I'm alive. So alive. Everybody loves the winner, but nobody loves the flop. No one works. excited, so come on, I'm ready, ready for the climb. Baby, it's my time. You believe it? I'm alive.
What a great song. Oh, my God.
Well,
that was bad.
Now you just went funny again. Can I say, what'd you say? What a something. I couldn't hear it.
What a great song.
No, I still can't hear you.
Oh.
Is that me or you?
Me, Blanca?
Oh, Blanca. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, now I can hear you. It was going
okay.
Watery, you know, like
oh,
you were
no.
Taking, swimming in the beautiful ocean.
We're in the Caribbean.
That song was great. What a powerful song. And you're such a tiny little woman. I mean, this is a powerhouse voice.
Yeah, well, it was a wonderful number. And it was, you know, Applause is the musical of the movie of All About Eve.
Yes.
With Bette Davis and Ann Baxter.
Right.
Did you know that? You must have known that. But
yes.
I don't know if all your audience knows it. So it's about
right.
A younger actress and an older actress and all the things that implies. And this was the moment when Eve got her chance. And the But Alive part of the song was something Bacall sang earlier, Margot Channing, played by Lauren Bacall. And so that's incorporated in this. But I just get my chance, and I'm on my way to being, you know, the big whatever.
The big
and that's why
star.
She says all that stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you can feel it. It's a really beautiful song. Really great number.
I was lucky to get that number. I mean, it's really, it was hard to play that show for a long time because it was all so, ooh, I'm going to get mine. You know, it was
right.
Really hard to go through that every day. But I was lucky to have it. So there I am. That's my legend.
That's my legacy. All that stamina. It is a legacy. It really is fantastic. You should
yeah.
be really proud of that work. It's beautiful.
I sounded very young. I still sing it, and I sing it in the same key, but I don't sound so young. I don't know what it is. I guess I'm just darker in the sound. But I was just thinking, my God, she sounds young.
Aw.
Young, just so full of energy and life, and it's a beautiful, beautiful song.
We have the fantastic Penny Fuller on our show. If you'd like to call in and talk to Penny, you can call us at 516-418-5590. But we will be right back after these messages with the great Penny Fuller. We'll be right back.
You're listening to Michael Massey, broadcasting live from Anguilla. We'll be right back.
Taking a family of five to the amusement park can cost a small fortune.
Oh, yeah. So to save some money, we thought, hey, let's bring the amusement park to us.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
All right. Step right up, young man. Are you ready to ride the Wacky Waterfall?
That's just the bathtub with the shower head running.
Nope, it's the Wacky Waterfall.
It's the shower, Dad.
Waterfall.
Wacky.
There's an easier way to save. To get a free rate quote, go to geico.com. Then buy online, over the phone, or at your local Geico office.
Bobby, you're here again.
Yeah, my doctor told me to reduce stress at work, so I come to Buffalo Wild Wings to eat lunch and watch sports. I get to pick one of seven entrees, like sandwiches and salads, plus one of seven sides.
Well, I like sides.
It's so affordable, I can finally take a vacation.
Where are you going to go?
Here, Tim, here.
Introducing the new B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch Menu, starting at a new low price. Dine in or order takeout weekdays between 11 and 2. Participation and availability may vary. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
You're listening to Michael Massey Live. If you'd like to join the Michael Massey Live show on the air, call area code 516-418-5590. And now, back to the show.
And we are back to the Michael Massey Live show, and we're here with Penny Fuller. Penny, tell me about the show, A New Brain. Tell me about that show.
Well, it's very interesting. William Finn, who had won Tonys for falsettos and I think maybe something else, maybe just falsettos, I can't remember. I was living in Los Angeles at the time. And he was crossing the street, and he dropped to the street, and they took him to the hospital, and he had, I can't remember the name of it now, but a terrible thing with his brain, but they thought it was brain cancer and he's going to die, a tumor, and he's going to die. Okay. And so Wendy Wasserstein, the wonderful playwright, and some more of his friends, when he didn't die, and when they realized they kept doing tests, they got somehow, I don't know how this happened, but they got a piano up to his room, and he began writing songs while he thinking that this was going to be the last songs he ever wrote. And then they found out it wasn't a brain tumor, it was this other thing. And they operated, and he lived, and he was fine to write, what's the school show? You know, the musical about, oh, God, what's the name of it? Anyway, the Spelling Bee, and
okay.
other things. And he had these songs, and he thought, well, maybe they'd make a review. And then James Lapine said, no, let's write the story. So they made up, it wasn't about Bill. It was what happened to Bill, but it was another story. And they wrote it. And he had always wanted me to play his mother. He remembered me, he says, from when he saw me in Applause.
Oh,
and
okay.
So eventually, and I didn't know who he was because I had been in L.A. during his falsettos days, which they are reviving this year on Broadway, so I'll get to see it at last.
Wonderful.
And so he had me play his mother, and I kept thinking, he's a great big sort of truck driver kind of guy who's Jewish, and I'm sort of small and blonde and not Jewish. And then when we did a reading of the play, his mother was there, and I saw her, and I understood why he wanted me to play her. I looked very much like her.
Oh,
and
really? Okay.
So they wrote this play, and I played his mother, and it was set to music. And now they just did it in encores to a huge success. But I think it was a little maybe early when this one was done because it didn't, when the one I did, it had its cult, you know, following.
Right.
But the critics didn't, I don't think they were ready for it.
Oh,
but
okay.
it was fantastic. I loved it. It's one of the favorite things I've ever done. And it was all about a kind of redemption, you know, but very funny and very quirky, which Bill is. And I, as I say, I was lucky enough to play his mother in the play.
I was listening to all the music, the whole soundtrack of the show, and the music's just fantastic.
Isn't it fantastic?
You know, it really is. I love it. And it's funny. I mean, it's pretty bold. You know, there's bold music
yeah,
that comes out of it.
Yeah, exactly.
Risque. But no, there's a song that you do that I'd like to play for everybody.
I know which one.
The music still plays on. It's a beautiful song. The music still plays on. So this is a special treat.
You want me
for
to tell you how that comes up?
Yes,
please
do.
Well, he has the operation in the play. And
yes.
while his head is bandaged, he has all these hallucinations of everybody that you've met in the show before. And then suddenly a piano rolls by, and he gets up from the bed. This is all a hallucination in his coming out of the operation. And he sits at the piano, and he writes this song that he thinks his mother will sing if he dies. And then she comes out dressed like in a gown, a real cabaret glamour, 1940s kind of stork club kind of gown and setting, and sings this ballad.
Well, I'm glad you set this up because it gives the song so much meaning. Again, the song is "The Music Still Plays On." This is from A New Brain. Take a listen.
And I freeze. No.
thinks I'll be when he dies. I'll be gracious and aloof, or I'll climb on the roof, shouting obscenities. He was here and now he's gone. The music still plays on. The music still plays on and on and on and on. Loud and fast and clear, the music still plays on and on and on and on. Even though you're not here, my dear, married too young, I was brash, I was bold. And divorced far too old. Husband sleeker than a horse, he rears and flies off course. I liked his pedigree. Love is here and then it's gone. The music still plays on. Plays on and on and on and on. As my men depart, the music still plays on and on and on and on. Transmitted through my foolish heart. So stay away. I'm okay, I'm ahead. What came to pass? One's an ass, one is dead. Love is stupid and it bleeds. It satisfies my needs. I think it's wonderful. Once it was wonderful. Love is here and then it's gone. The music still plays on. They were here and now they're gone. The music still plays on and on and on.
Wow. You know, we're...
Penny, I'm crying.
Both of us are sitting here choked up. That... What a beautiful, beautiful song.
That was gorgeous.
It is, isn't it? Yeah, it really
well,
is.
Oh, well, I have to say that while Blanca and
here's
I compose ourselves.
Oh, man.
We're going to compose ourselves.
Here comes my phone ringing.
Don't worry. We're going to go to commercial. We'll be right back.
I got to wipe my mascara off my face.
Hi, friends. This is Michael Masci, and let me tell you about the Cuisinart Golf Resort and Spa. 98 luxurious suites and villas, an 18-hole Greg Norman-designed golf course, the Venus Day Spa, 5 fabulous restaurants, all situated on the most beautiful beach in the Caribbean, Rendezvous Bay. Be sure to check out all of our summer promotions and packages at www.cuisinartresort.com or call to make a reservation, 1-800-943-3210, and tell them Michael Masci told you to call.
You're listening to Michael Masci Live. If you'd like to join the Michael Masci Live show on the air, call area code 516-418-5590. And now, back to the show.
And we are back with Penny Fuller. Penny, how are you doing with the show? You doing okay?
I'm doing fine, but that was one of those grim calls. Ask your audience if anybody has one of those do not call.gov things I can call them back. Oh, it was hello, seniors.
Oh,
hello, seniors. You need to, I don't know, whatever it was. Oh,
you got to tell them, do you know you're interrupting my radio interview?
My radio show, you robot.
How dare them. No, that song was just, my God. Blanca wants to ask you a question about that song.
I need to find out how could you sing that song so beautifully and not lose it on stage?
Well, there are several answers to that. One is the job is to sing the song, you know.
Right.
Yes.
And the second thing is the job is to, to send the message out to the audience, to give the gift of the song to the audience, which is more important than my tears. And the third time is they didn't mind if I had some tears rolling down during the song. Mm.
It's very powerful.
The melody is just so moving. Music does that to us, and it just hits right in the heart. But the way that you sang it just beautifully, you knew when to be so soft and when to really be singing so powerful. Just beautiful. I mean,
thank you. I loved doing that, you know.
Yeah, we really had to go to commercial. We were both choked up.
Oh, my gosh. I have my false eyelashes on. I had to...
Don't do that again.
Oh, God. I hear them falling to the floor. The mascara, the eyelashes,
the
everything.
The mascara, the eyelashes are just falling right off.
Now I'll pick them up for you, sweetheart.
Oh, yes. You know my secret.
No, but for those of you that are listening to the show and would like to talk to Penny, you can call us at 516-418-5590. And of course, we're talking to Penny about all the wonderful accomplishments, movies, television, Broadway, you know, and to talk about another show on Broadway, tell us about the show Rex, for those that do not know about that show.
Well, there's a reason they don't know. And that is because it was the next to the last show that Richard Rodgers ever wrote. And he wrote it with the only collaboration he ever had with one of the great lyricists, because by this time, Oscar Hammerstein had died. He wrote it with Sherman Yellen. And it was a musical about Henry VIII and how he kept wanting to have a son to pass the kingdom on to. And and he had all these wives. Well, first he had this first wife, Catherine of Aragon, if anybody remembers their history. And then she had a girl who was Mary Tudor. Bloody Mary, they called her. She was still Catholic, and then the country became Protestant, and Henry went over to France to have a treaty with France, and he met this young English girl who was in the French court named Anne Boleyn, fell madly in love with her, brought her back to England, and made her queen, and expected a baby boy from her, and she produced Elizabeth, who later became Queen Elizabeth I of England, the greatest monarch, blah, blah, blah. No girls. Then he married Jane Seymour, and she produced a very weak little boy who eventually died at the age of 12, and that's why Elizabeth became queen. But it's about his search to find a son, not just male ego, but to leave the country to run the country. And it's male heir, right. So it's a very interesting time in British history. And so that's what this musical was theoretically about. And Nicol Williamson, who was a really fine, great Scottish actor, and who could sing, but he played the part, and he was of Henry, and he was a little difficult. I'm just speaking quite gently. And I played Anne Boleyn in the first act, and our little scamp of a daughter, Princess Elizabeth, who becomes queen in the second act. So I had a wonderful time, and I was thrilled because I'd actually been trained as a classical actress and not as a singer, so I got to bring all of my tools to the table. And I think, do you want me to talk about the song that's coming that you wanted
Absolutely.
To play?
Sure.
Well, this is a song that was cut from the show, actually.
Really?
But what happened is,
okay.
But it was on the CD for real.
Right.
But I come in and I find him after having birthed the baby Elizabeth with the red hair, and I say, and he's playing around with Jane Seymour, who becomes his next wife after he beheads me. And he, I say, get her out of here. And he says, don't tell me what to do. I mean, it's a little, but Sherman Yellen's dialogue was better than this. And he says, I say, come to bed with me and we'll make sons. And he says, lady, I brought you up. I can bring you down. And he walks off. And I sing this song. As
nice guy.
What a husband.
Yeah. Well, what is it? Died, beheaded, something died, beheaded. I mean, there's some little thing about the wives, the six wives of Henry VIII.
Yeah.
Right.
Died, divorced, died, beheaded, divorced, died, beheaded, divorced, I think it is.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, we're going to play for everybody this song that I guess was cut from the show, but it's on the CD. It's a beautiful song.
Yes, and it's a love song that she sang to Henry after he sort of told her that she's had it, kind of.
Penny Fuller and So Much You Love Me.
Yesterday, your eyes were bright with love, your face alight with love, so much you loved me. Yesterday, your laughter rang with love, each gesture sang with love, so much you loved me. You were a warming fire, you were the sun at noon, alone that has burned so brightly turned to cold gray ash so soon. Ours, you said, was an undying love, but our undying love has proved a lie. As a star can fall from the filled an hour of love with fervent sighing. Yesterday, were you aware at all, and did you care at all, that love was dying? Gone is the warming fire, has burned so brightly, turned to cold gray ash too soon. Ours, you said, would be a lasting love. It seems that lasting love has passed us by. As a star can fall from the
fantastic song, Penny.
Really gorgeous.
Oh, Richard Rodgers.
Really, really wonderful, wonderful song. I want to tell you that our son is so curious to talk with you. He wanted to say hello. This is our 6-year-old. This is Richie. Richie, this is Penny Fuller. Can you say hello?
Hi, Penny Fuller.
Hello, Richie. How are you? What are you doing? Besides talking to me.
What are you doing?
I was watching TV and I was being a little noisy.
Yeah, you were being a little noisy up there.
Oh, you were. Was that noise you? Wow, I heard that.
Yeah. I'm in second grade.
Yeah.
You're in the second grade. My goodness. What's your teacher's name?
Mommy.
Or you haven't started school yet.
No, Mommy is a teacher.
Mommy's a teacher.
We homeschool here in Anguilla.
Yeah. Oh, you homeschool, yes.
Yeah.
But why? What's the population of Anguilla? 10?
It's 14,000, but we follow the American curriculum because this is British West Indies. So it's different holidays, different stuff. And so with all it's too tough to learn new holidays at my age.
Right.
So thank you, Richie, and I'm glad you got to say hello to Miss Fuller.
Oh, thank you, Richie. I love talking to you. You do well in homeschool now, okay?
Okay.
All righty.
He's our next entertainer, let me tell you.
He's the only one of our children who likes entertaining.
That's right.
Isn't that interesting? Wow.
He was really anxious to say hello to you.
He really was. He was making noises up there.
Well, isn't that nice? Now I'm really flattered. I mean, you two are great, but I mean, Richie, that's the big time.
Well, now let's talk about you in Sin Twisters 2, T-O-O.
Okay. Well, the whole point of Sin Twisters is that Anita and I, for years, have been taken for each other. There are pictures of me on her IDBM, whatever it's called, page, you know, where you look her up in the
IMDb.
Yeah, that. And I used to have red hair.
We have Anita on the line. We have Anita on the line right now. Hi, Anita.
Hi, hon. I try to get those pictures off there, and they wouldn't listen to me. I told them to leave them on. I need all the help I can get.
Well, why aren't mine on yours?
Your IMDb is all Penny.
Oh, my goodness.
Have you got the coffee made? Because after this show, I'm coming up to rehearse.
I didn't know if you wanted coffee or tea. I just brought back from London some great tea.
Either one is fine.
Right.
Okay. I can't wait to see you.
Listen, you're keeping my buddy there. We're getting ready to start rehearsal soon.
Well, you can use some rehearsal, darling. You can work without me.
You got that right, kid.
I'll see you soon.
Wait a minute.
I'll see you soon.
Anita.
I'll be up there by 1:30.
Okay, honey bun.
Okay, darling. I can't wait to see you.
Anita Gillette is going to be on our show on the 31st. In case you didn't realize, Anita, you're going to be on our show on the 31st.
Right.
I knew that. Richard Skipper told me that.
That's right.
I can't wait.
You're so adorable. Can I get you girls to do a duet on the line?
That might be that difficult.
I think
they
can do it.
Look at you. Without the piano. Look at you. Look at me. How much more alike could two girls be? Here we stand.
That's
sisters.
My line.
Oh, that's your line.
My
okay.
Line.
See, I do need rehearsal. Okay. Boy, do we need to rehearse.
I love it.
That was just a touch of it. It was fantastic.
Oh, you're adorable. I love it.
Anita, thank you for calling
me. You could come up from Anguilla and see it.
Oh. You're not kidding.
Have you got a venue in Anguilla? Maybe we could come down there.
In all seriousness, we are working on that. We are definitely working on
it. Oh, good. Well, hurry up.
The Peanut Resort has a new resort called The Reef, and it's going to have a beautiful venue.
We would love to bring the shows here.
Yeah.
Oh, great. Oh. And I know that Richie will be in the front row.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
Oh, no, he'll be on the stage with you for that.
Yes, right.
Sin Twisters 3.
Yeah,
we might be able to use him, you know?
I love it.
Oh, and what an after party we will have.
Oh, my goodness. We're all preparing for the after party.
Absolutely.
Well, we better learn our song first because we've got
I'm going to get off and let you guys go. Everybody come and see Sin Twisters. So,
absolutely.
And Penny will give you all the details.
Yes,
I will.
Thank you, Anita.
I'll see you next week.
Thank you, Anita.
Thank you, Penny.
I'll see you later,
Penny
Fuller. Miss Fuller. Thank you. See you soon. Bye-bye.
All right, we're going to stop this love fest now.
It's a big love fest. We're like all kissing the mic.
This is hilarious.
No, I love it. This is wonderful. So, tell us more about Sin Twisters 2.
Well, we did send Twisters. But 2 years ago at 54 Below, and which is a club in New York, and then we took it to London. And then we wanted to, so we've fashioned a new one. I mean, it's some of the stuff from the old show, because, and then some new stuff, so that's why we don't quite remember it, because we've only done it twice. And that's right. Why we're doing it at the Actors Home. But it's a show that mm-hmm. talks about the glory days of the 60s and 70s of Broadway, which we were both a part of, and mm-hmm. about how, as I was saying, how we were always taken for each other. Only I, and during those days, I had red hair because I was doing a show, and Robert Redford, whom I'd done Barefoot in the Park with, said came to see it, and he said, why don't you dye your hair red? So what am I going to do, not do what Robert Redford says?
Exactly.
So I dyed my hair red, and we looked even more alike. Anita
wow.
and me. So so it sort of began like, you know, everybody would mistake us. And then we kind of knew each other sort of waving across the room. And then about 7 or 8 years ago, we were at Len Carew, the original Sweeney Todd, his apartment for Christmas. And we were standing in the hallway with a glass of wine, the two of us, beginning to get to know each other, and we leaned against the wall, and we kept mm-hmm. talking, and the longer we leaned, we finally slid down to the floor with our legs across the little hallway, and we sat there for an hour getting to know each other, and we've been, you know, just very close ever since. And we got this idea, and, well, actually, it was our director, Barry Kleinbord's idea, mm-hmm. and we got this idea to do the show, and we did, and we have this fabulous music director named Paul Greenwood, and we've had wonderful bass players. This time we have Rit Hen, his name is, and we do this show. And it's, as I say, it's about a lot of songs from the glory age of Broadway and kind of the competition between us, but it's all fun, and the one-upmanship. And then we have a surprise section, which I will take the surprise out of and tell you, because we both did cabaret, the musical mm-hmm. cabaret. So we do a whole right. thing about doing cabaret. And it's sort of her career and my career and when they touched and competed and when we went off on our own thing, too. Because the irony is Anita came to New York as a singer wanting to act, and I came as an actress who fell into singing.
Right.
By accident. And so she wanted to do more, and she eventually did more classic roles and was nominated for a Tony for a straight play, Chapter 2 by Neil Simon. And I was nominated for a Tony for a musical, Applause. The irony being that she was the singer and I was the actress.
Right. Well, it sounds like a lot of fun.
It is a lot of fun. And things go wrong all the time.
I mean, oh, we know.
There was the saga of the earring in the last show that became the best part of the whole show because my earring kept falling off.
Oh,
you know,
no.
Those kinds of things.
That's great. That's great. And for those of you that we'll be sure to promote this all over Facebook and social media. And, and of course, on the show page, we'll have the information on how to buy tickets and when the show's going to be.
Great.
But no, but
do you
Penny,
want me to
it
say
is,
it anyway?
Yes,
yes please
do.
It's at the Metropolitan Room, which is on West 22nd Street between 5th and 6th. I can't remember the exact address, but you'll see it. And okay. It's June the 3rd and June the 9th at 7 o'clock. The Metropolitan Room. Send Twisters, comma, T-O-O.
That is wonderful. And, boy, I wish we could be there to see it.
I wish Rick could be there.
I'm sure he would love it, too.
I think our little guy is definitely a thespian at heart. I really do. We're thinking about opening up a drama school here in Anguilla because there is no drama school for children. And knowing that it's so important for people like us with our skill set, I find that local children here definitely need something like that. So we would love
it. It's really a wonderful thing.
You here.
Even if they don't want to be actors when they grow up. Gets them in touch with something that they don't really know is there in themselves.
You know, it leads me to my last question for you, and that is, with all of your experience, what would you tell those folks out there that are trying to break into Broadway and theater? What's your best advice to them?
Oi.
I know.
That's
it's
hard.
A complicated question.
Oi,
it's very
right.
hard.
Mm-hmm.
Because you know how many people are trying.
If you don't have to do it, don't do it. If you have to do it, do it. And study and grow and watch human beings and watch your own feelings, because all of that will go into what the people you're portraying. But if it's not life and death to you, then do something else and go enjoy the theater. But if it's life and death, if you really are so driven that you have to express yourself in that way, then don't deny that and be very stalwart and do your work and care.
Mm-hmm. I think that's great advice.
I think it's wonderful advice. He's not, but he will be later. He will be,
he'll be
during the rebroadcast. But that's such great advice, because so many parents, I feel, want to push their children into it, to have their children become the next current icon, whether it's...
Oh, really? See, in my day, they didn't want us to do that.
A lot of parents...
My parents were very supportive, I'm happy to say, but most parents are not. Well, you got to get another job to keep, you got to be a lawyer first. Or whatever.
That's basically it. And, a lot of these people, they are lawyers or they are doctors or they are, in other types of professions, and they want to put their children in these classes to get their kids primed, to be out there and be the lead in the play and be the lead in this. And
no, it has to come from inside of you. It has to be inside of you. The drive has to be there. If you want it, as I say, if it's something you enjoy, then do it as an avocation. But unless you just feel I'll die if I don't express myself through music or theater, then don't do it.
Yes.
Too hard.
It is.
Punishing.
But I do feel that it's important for children, all children, to be exposed to it in their youth so that they can realize that this is there. A lot of children also, conversely, repress their feelings and don't know that it's okay to express their feelings in healthy ways. So, like in my situation, my mother, being in the she wanted to be a psychology major and was in child development, she saw that I was such a painfully shy child and that I wouldn't express my feelings. She knew that there was a lot more there, and it was through her encouragement that really opened up the Pandora's box. So I
Isn't
do see that.
That's fabulous. Yeah.
I thank my mother every day, because it was really the portal to allow for me to express all of those feelings and to really make it in TV and to have this kind of similar experience with yours. And there are a lot of children that just are taught to brush it off or not to express their emotions as well. So you've got two sets of parents that try nowadays that want to push their children to be the next Broadway star, and sing for the audience. Go ahead, do it. But then there are other parents that are encouraging. There's a difference between pushiness and encouraging.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Well, Penny, we thank you so much for being our guest today.
Well, I thank you. I've had a lovely time.
We're having a great time. I want to keep talking, but Richie's precariously dancing around all of my board and our electronics. Richie, come over here and
we wish you the best of luck in the show. And
thank you.
You're welcome to be a part of our show anytime. So anytime you want to call
in. Well, I'll call in one day. I may even
anytime.
Call in and nag Anita. But I may call in when you least expect it. So
anytime. And
well,
of course,
thank you so much.
You are wonderful. And of course, visit us here at the Cuisinart Resort sometime in Anguilla. You deserve a vacation once in a while.
Absolutely.
We'll have a great
wonderful.
Time.
Yes.
That sounds really great. What is it called?
The Cuisinart, like the appliances, the Cuisinart Resort.
Oh, it is.
Yes.
Oh.
Golf resort.
Do I have
spa.
To be in a blend? Do I have to get in a blender?
Do you know that that's the one – Cuisinart Golf Resort and Spa does not sell any appliances.
Which is amazing.
It is amazing. You cannot get a blender there.
Oh, how funny.
Yeah.
How funny.
But no, anytime.
But it's world-class food, and it's absolutely a breathtaking scenery. The owner of the resort, really put a lot of care into the details to make it – you look like you're really in Mykonos in Greece. It's gorgeous.
Oh, yeah.
It's beautiful architecture.
How great.
Yeah, so it's fun. We've got to have you come over, and we'll enjoy sitting on Rendezvous Beach and having a frozen mojito as we're talking about your
great.
Next.
I think I won't go to rehearsal today. I think I'll just get a flight now.
You talk about it with Miss Gillette, and you let her know, okay, they're telling us we got to come up with another show so we could be down there in Rendezvous Bay.
Right.
Oh, Penny, thank you again.
Thank you. I wish you all the very best, and you too, Richie. And I just may come down. You just never know.
That would be wonderful.
The door and it's me.
It would be our pleasure.
You just give us a call anytime. All right. Thank you, Penny.
Thank you very much. Bye.
All right. Bye-bye now. That's the great Penny Fuller. Richie, what are you going to say something? She actually is. She can hear you, but she's not on the air.
Just go on MichaelMasheyLive.com.
Oh, wow. What a good advertiser. Michael Mashey, that is true. You can go to MichaelMasheyLive.com to see any of our archive shows or some of the shows that are being scheduled that are coming up soon. Again, that's MichaelMasheyLive.com. And we're on Facebook. I'd love for you to be able to follow our Facebook page. It's Facebook.com/MichaelMasheyLive. Very simple. And a Twitter at Michael Mashey. So, and again, all these shows are archived, and this particular show page is going to give you all that information about Penny Fuller and Anita Gillette in their fantastic show, Sin Twisters 2. So be sure to check that information out. And Blanca, another fantastic show with another fantastic guest.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Really fantastic.
Yeah. Or you can go on www.michaelmasheylive.com.
Yes, you can do that too. I guess he's really stuck on that.
This is our IT man right here.
I like that. Thank you so much. I'll pay you after the show, okay? But anyway, thank you for that. But another wonderful show, like I said. And thank you, Penny Fuller, for another fantastic show.
What a darling guest.
She's wonderful.
Yes, her and Anita Gillette on the phone. That was adorable. Yeah, and then the duet.
I love that. Right on cue.
Awesome.
For those of you that maybe do not know Penny Fuller, and I don't think there's many that don't know her, she's just incredible history. Look her up. She has so many credits to her name. And don't forget to join us tomorrow, too. At noon Eastern Standard Time, we have Joan Ellison. She's going to be on our show tomorrow. And we're going to be talking about her show that's a tribute to the great Judy Garland. And, again, Anita Gillette on May 31st, but you can just check out the show and you'll see when all these things are coming up. But thank you, my darling. Thank you, Blanca.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Richie.
You're welcome.
And we will see you soon.
And thank you, listeners.
Oh, and I want to thank all of the callers that called in, too. Thank you to all of you. And don't forget, Richard Skipper celebrates on May 25th, Wednesday, for all of you in the New York area. May 25th, 8 o'clock at the Triad Theater in New York. All right. We'll see you soon, folks.
You've been listening to The Michael Mashey Show. If you'd like to promote your business or upcoming event, contact the show at info@michaelmasheylive.com. Go to www.michaelmasheylive.com to follow the show and receive email notifications when we're going live with future shows. Share this website on Facebook, Twitter, and email. You can follow Michael on Twitter at Mike and Anguilla or on Facebook at Michael Mashey Live. Join us for our next broadcast. Ciao for now.
Bye for now, Doug.